How's your AC working out at the fire station?
As long as the one's on in the captain's room, I'm good. If they shut the, on the captain's room off, it gets warm. But I know the ceiling fan, so. My room itself doesn't have one.
Yeah, we have no control here.
None?
No, not really.
Oh, wow.
It's crazy.
So that changed?
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay.
Energy efficient thing is, works opposite.
Awesome.
Yeah.
And we have, still have window units? Well, they're stuck in them.
Yeah.
So it depends on which group. Some of them like it freezing, some of it like it.
It doesn't work at all, it just blows me. It doesn't blow hot or cold.
Awesome.
What's the difference between Department 13 and Department 12?
On budget and DPW budget?
So it must have been bright in the hot and humid in summer.
Yeah, like we say, all day long, trying to lower the zone temperature so it can kick on. Fire in four or five guys at one time.
Yep.
No hot bodies.
Of course, yep. Heats up a room very quickly.
If you have to stay late from work, it's on full time. Everyone leaves the building and it gets like really cold. Like you have to go and turn the room temperature up to get it to go off. Same thing with the weekend, like it's reversed program.
That's
or something.
Weird.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
And it can only go between the temperatures of 68 and 74. And go
it won't.
Higher or lower than
that. Oh, okay. Awesome.
Pretty much only keeps on for 3 minutes and shut it off.
Nice. Mm. That's crazy.
I don't think it means 20.
Yeah, so one is 13.
Okay.
Budget 13.
Do you need anything set up?
Yeah, just to sit.
Okay.
So I'll be here. Sorry.
Okay.
How long do you want to wait?
5:30.
I don't mind waiting a little bit. But
you didn't go down to Melwood, did you?
I haven't heard from him since the last meeting. He hasn't replied to any of the emails.
He replied to one.
Yeah.
I can't remember which one it was.
Yeah.
I'll make a motion to open it.
Second, I guess. I can second it.
Yeah.
All those in favor?
Aye.
We did payroll warrants. We need to vote on the meeting minutes that we all signed at the last meeting.
Yeah, I'll make a motion to that effect to approve the minutes of the last meeting.
Not the meeting.
The meeting prior.
The prior meeting, the last meeting.
Right.
Second. Aye.
Aye.
Do we have meetings from the last minute? Minutes from
the
last
meeting?
She's
still in the process of doing it. She's pretty much finished as of today. She's just going to have Jean look them over and then email them to you guys.
Okay.
So, she's started the billing process, so she's up on that.
Eagle Scout.
Wanna be.
Eagle Scout project.
Yep.
What's up?
Go ahead, Al.
My name is Alec Frazier. I'm a Life Scout in Troop 34 in Hanson, and my plan for the Eagle Scout project, me and Mr. McPhillips, who works in the Veterans Office, have been talking, and we want to raise money through fundraising, and have a plaque made for his son Brian McPhillips, who has a memorial island at the end of my street, which is Monroe Street here in Pembroke. And we want the plaque made so like his name, his rank in the military, the day he was born to the day that he passed away, and maybe a brief description about his death. We're not sure on that piece of it yet. And then we want to have the plaque nailed onto a rock, or put onto a rock, and then the rock put onto the island. and then two rebars stuck in on either side of the rock so that during Memorial Day and Veterans Day, we can hang an American flag and a the branch of the military flag that he was in on either rebar, and then maybe put some new flowers in around the rock, depending on what the garden group wants us to do.
And that's at Monroe and Hobmock, okay. That island right there.
Okay. Any issues on maintenance-wise, Gina?
When would you be looking to do this? Because we've got some changes coming up to that island as part of our sidewalk project.
Okay, we did hear that.
I was thinking maybe hopefully getting it started by next spring, maybe next summer. I'm not 100% sure yet. That was like the time frame I was looking at.
Okay, because I'm not sure of the time frame on that yet. I'm going to be having another meeting the next couple of weeks, so I'll have a better idea when that's going to kick off as far as the actual movement of the island.
Okay.
In shape, so we'll just keep that in mind with your project.
Okay. Thank you.
No issues with maintenance or anything like that with having something like that?
I don't think so. There hasn't been with the Memorial Island that's currently there now.
And are you making that island smaller?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Potentially.
Okay.
Do we have plans yet or no?
Yes,
there's two sets.
Yeah, we went. It was three options, and we all agreed on the middle one. So it won't be as small as original, but it'll be different placement than what it is now in shape. And I can get you a copy of that, too, if it helps with what you're going to try and lay out as far as your rock and sign and the garden club for the flowers.
That'd be great. Thank you.
And then what about Mr. McPhillips and the rock?
Mm-hmm.
What about Mr. McPhillips and the rock? I was going to ask to get a rock down at some time.
Oh, yes. And then we were wondering if we could go into the cemetery and look at some of the rocks that are in there, and then ask the DPW if you guys would bring the rock over to the island for me.
I'm sure that can be arranged.
I don't see any issue with that.
Do we have rocks down at the Monroe Pit?
I'll have to check.
Not where we used to store them.
Yeah. We'll have to see if there's any left down there.
I was going to say we can walk down there too. So that's... Right.
I have plenty of rocks.
Cool.
I have plenty of rocks at my house. If you guys need any extra rocks. I don't live in a rocky part of town.
Nice.
I have no issues with it. Do you have any, Paul?
No. No.
I think it's a great idea.
We need it in a motion now. Or is it something that we're going to have to wait until the design?
I don't see any. I don't know if we. What is it? We're just making a motion to allow it to happen?
Mm-hmm. Do we have an approved. I know there was some maybe issues with the design with Mr. Phillips.
No.
This happened.
There was three different sizes, so
right.
We agreed on the middle.
Okay.
So it won't be as big as it is now, but it won't be as small as the original proposed. It's a compromise in the middle of three options that we have.
Okay, so we're all settled on that?
Yes.
Okay. I'll make a motion to the effect that we allow the rock and island redesign.
Rock to be approved by
DPW?
You, Gene?
Okay.
The actual
size
and to make sure it doesn't, you know.
Just
for safety.
Oh, here's a. Oh, we love this 5 foot
and
thing.
And then the trucks
rock.
Can't make the turn.
Right. Yeah. So, just out of curiosity, in your project, you're going to come up with a plan, a design? Like if we give you a copy of the island, a proposed layout that could probably go with your project, so the Eagle Scouts, so now you have, you know, something that you can maybe look at the type of rock, so you have a design and how it's going to be laid out.
Yeah, I was going to talk to Mr. McPhillips some more, and we were going to make up a plan for how big we want the rock to be,
right.
Depending on the size of the island.
Right. Yeah, so because it's going to be your project,
mm-hmm.
and it's for your getting to Eagle, Gene Forlane could probably give you a copy of that little intersection so that you can use that as a to help you.
That'd
so
be
that you
excellent.
Have it. Moving forward.
Yeah.
Okay.
So a
awesome.
Motion to approve
allow the use.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
luck.
Thank you, guys.
There you go.
If you have anybody else that's looking for Eagle Scouts project, let me know.
Okay.
Especially if they want to build a rock wall or something.
No, I've been talking to your wife about using the online mapping to map all those...
all the layouts?
The monument poles throughout town.
Oh,
and then have
okay.
a website that you could then click on the monument pole and actually find out about the person that the monument's
oh, cool.
done.
You can tell Mr. Keene that tomorrow night?
Because
I know we've got a couple more coming up.
I've been trying to do it, Mary. I don't know how to. But my idea was to eventually put even those kind of monuments, you could basically put any kind of monument on there
mm-hmm.
and then have it, oh, you can click on that one and find out
okay.
about that person. So you're not, like, I joke because I was driving home one day and I drove by the end of, on Oldham Street at Wampatuck, there's one there, and then there's one on the corner of West Elm
yep.
in Oldham. And I was like, oh, I wonder who those, it happened to be right after Memorial Day, I'm like, oh, I wonder who
yeah.
I just drove by, because you see the flags, and I'm like, it would be, you could be able to go and look on the map and say, oh, you know, this was so-and-so, he was served in whatever war.
Yeah,
or,
well,
know,
that would be neat.
Stuff. Yeah, so. And then, like I said, all the different other monuments, too, and then eventually, hopefully, maybe map out all the people in the cemetery, too,
right.
long-term, the then veterans, so.
Cool.
Awesome.
Right.
So, yeah, let
thank
them know. We have
thank
ideas.
You.
I have
guys.
Ideas.
We'll
thank
pass
you.
Along to the other Pembroke, two Pembroke troops, too, and we'll let them know.
Awesome.
Some
yeah.
Oh, nice that you guys
thank you.
Thanks.
Senior discount rules and regulations. I happened to stop and talk to Sue about this because I emailed one out.
Right.
And the issue is there's no place written as to what...
The actual age is.
Not just the age. Who qualifies? Is it the
right.
owner of the building?
Well, it should be the people paying the... As far as I'm concerned, it should be who's paying the bill.
Right.
All right? So they, to me, are normally the property owner.
Yes.
And I had asked the question of Suvik in a in email. I don't include you guys on it because
and
I don't want it to be
a
public forum.
I said that to her when I came in this week. I
so
don't reply to anything
I had
for
said,
that same reason.
I had said, is 65 question the age or what? But it turns out in the town of Pembroke, when you take your trash bill and everything else around here is, I think it's 70.
No, there's two different ages, I want to say.
There is. So it's 65 for your property that can be abated. However,
okay.
financial information has to be submitted with that as well to get a discount on your property taxes.
Right.
Trash is 70.
Right. So the question is, I don't believe this.
But the discount's a lot bigger, too.
Right, but the question is, has there ever been...
There's nothing
so
in writing
back,
anywhere.
So look back through all of the books to find out when they decided to do the senior discount. She cannot find anything from previous boards.
Right.
In that big binder of stuff you gave us, was it in then, by any chance?
I think that's what she looked at, her own copy of it.
Oh, okay. Because
yeah.
I didn't have a chance to look through that, but that was,
that.
Yes, that
so,
giant
yeah.
book of knowledge.
Yes.
Yeah. So I guess the question is, do we probably should come up with an age.
An age and a requirement. You have to be
right.
the owner occupant.
Right. Not necessarily somebody within the dwelling.
Right.
Yeah.
And
but
it must be your main domicile. Cause
well,
the,
owner occupant.
Yeah. Well, the other thing is you have people that have multiple houses.
Some people are renters.
No, but
yes.
it's owner occupant. That's like City of Boston. If you want to rebid your taxes, you have to be owner occupant.
Right.
You have to live there.
Right. So there is no discount. So I'm clear, because sometimes, you know, you can say, well, this is what I thought, but I'm going to bring it up. So if you are renting or leasing property
mm-hmm.
in the town of Pembroke and you're not living on the property, even though you may be a senior, you're not eligible for it, because it's basically a business income. Is that what we're saying?
Well, the other question is, I guess it's a catch-22. I thought, and I don't know if this is a state, city, or whatever bylaw, I thought the owner had to pay the water bill.
We had that issue with the restaurant that we...
It's supposed to be, but I know there's a lot of paperwork out there. I happen to be one that the renters pay the water bills.
I'm just curious, because...
No, I always thought you were just the owner.
I always thought it was the owner, too, and the only reason why I asked that is because...
The one that stays in the owner's name.
Because then you're not allowing, if there's a senior that's renting an apartment to apply for a discount on her water, if she's being forced by her landlord to pay the water bill, or he or she is being forced to pay the water bill...
So that set up a catch-22, though. First off, the one reason that you, owner of a property may want them to pay the water bill is so that they can regulate it back and not abuse the water, all right? So therefore, it's part of, they're considering it part of their rent.
Yeah.
All right? So to me, legally, because if they don't pay their water bill, it's going to fall on the landowner.
Yes.
That the key is that, first off, if the landowner is not living there, he ain't getting a discount anyway.
So I'd say voter, I'd say owner occupant 65 years or older.
Right. Okay.
That sound fair?
Yep.
And we can put that in the regs, because we're going to be updating the rules and regs as part of our master plan, as it's so updated.
I'll make a motion to that effect.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Done.
So while we're on water.
Yep.
I was wondering, when, because we're ahead of the game right here, right? Time-wise?
Sure. We are way ahead of the game.
Quick question on wells.
Mm-hmm. It's good for YouTube.
Quick question on wells. When somebody puts a well in the town of Pembroke, all right, what is the DPW's responsibility for that well?
We go out after it's been installed and make sure it's not a cross connection in the house between our potable water and their well.
Okay. Are these all registered?
With the Board of Health.
With the Board of Health.
And so with the Board of Health, we have documentation of locations.
Yeah, latitudes and longitudes.
Do we?
Yep. I know, because I pulled a permit.
Okay.
So they require you get the latitude and longitude of where you put your well.
Right. And so each well owner has a number?
I'm not positive about the number, but I would...
The only reason I said
they're supposed to, but
supposed
I'm not
to
sure.
The registration number, correct?
I'm not sure if they have a difference between irrigation wells or drinking wells.
Yeah.
Or if they're just whatever well goes in town.
No, because they have the same setbacks for an irrigation well as they do a domestic well.
Right. I'm just wondering, because I see wells go in, I don't see plaques when I used to see plaques, and I used to see registration numbers on wells, and now I don't see them.
Well, if you just did it, do they require you to do one for them? Because it would be the Board of Health that would require.
I pulled the permit, I paid the permit, I paid the DPW.
Who do you pay the DPW?
For the backflow check.
Okay, what's that? How much is that?
$35 for the inspection.
I don't think this, to be honest with you, there might have been a thing to say put a sign out. I don't know. I can't remember, to be honest with you.
You see that in other towns, especially, and the only reason I say that now is because when you drive through towns now that have water vans, you see people who have green lawns, all right?
Yeah, they have the sign out.
And they have the sign out.
And you know how many of those people that they go up and take the chlorine sample and they have town water? A lot.
Right. And so I just want to make sure that we're actually following that.
Yeah, because you need it next year with the new Water Management Act permit that we know we're going to have water restrictions.
We will have water restrictions next summer, guaranteed.
Yeah. And then they're probably going to want to know how many wells we have in town, besides our own.
They haven't gotten to that point yet. There's talk of trying to regulate private water. I know Norwell actually had the discussion as to why Board of Health is allowing people to put more wells in when people are on water bans, because it's the same aquifer. So
that I can see there's going to be a regulation and not going to be able to put one in because of
if you put one in you're going to be on the same restrictions as the town's on at some point. But then it's going to be a lot of issues with that because of the fact of
you get deep wells, you get shallow wells.
No, but you've got personal property questions as to
right.
what you can do on your own personal property versus what you can.
Because there's some homeowners that just have well water, don't have town water, so.
Right. No, and that's fine, because I'm assuming they, do they have to get their water tested?
Yes.
And bring it to the health board? I mean, or how do they do it? Or is it self-regulating?
They self-regulate, but you do, you're supposed to test your water instead of your certain, often, yeah. But yes, if you looked at the thing that we just got from DEP today, that we are going to have the, not that.
Not that one.
The one, did you see it?
I haven't had a chance to read it yet.
We got the draft Water Management Act permit. You might want to send it to these two for review before our next meeting. It will be, by the time our next meeting, probably, it will be officially out in draft format for comment by the watershed associations and other.
Okay, so have they finalized the determination of towns that draw off of surface water versus well water?
No, they still can't put that in the model.
You know what I mean?
Trust me, I've had that discussion, and he is willing, the DEP is willing to come in and talk. We just, every time we schedule a meeting with him, we then cancel it, so then I'm now to the point where it's like, we have other stuff on the agenda, so let's
maybe
wait till the winter when we all know we're going to be here.
It's going to become a big thing, I mean, especially where they wanted to pull out, they pulled out the dams.
And the other one is, I think when we do have that meeting, we should do a joint with the selectmen, because that permit is going to come to the selectmen, not to us. It's going to be, the new Water Management Act permit is addressed to the Board of Selectmen, not to Public Works. So there's no negative to having a joint, because if they have questions, we might as well get an answer from the horse's mouth versus ours. Anything else on that?
No, we haven't moved. No, let me just go into this here, because isn't this part of
special town meeting articles?
Well, because some of them have to do with the water, right?
Yeah.
We're going into that.
Yeah,
right,
special
now?
Town meeting articles. Yes. Okay. And first on that is the RFQ. I finished it up. I made extra copies that I'm going to drop off with Sabrina too, for the sake of letting the selectmen know what our game plan is. So. If everybody wants to take a look at this by next meeting,
right.
I'll fill in the dates.
Okay.
Based on next meeting, if you have any comments, let me know before then.
Okay.
This is the same thing I sent out
before. Right,
before.
So it's not,
just any comments before then, and I will plan on advertising it after the next meeting, so we can have one last bite at the apple, but I'm going to have it ready to go for advertise in the Central Register after the Tuesday after our next meeting.
I gave Luke Stone a heads up about this. He was on that site walk we did for the 40B going in off of Birch Street this afternoon.
Yeah.
And he was asking. So I told him it was supposed to be last year.
Yeah.
Thought it was going to be DPW, police and fire all submitted at one.
Yeah.
Didn't happen, so the commissioners are just submitting it now.
Yeah. Yeah.
I guess they just got their draft for the home.
Yeah. I figured that was going to be coming. That's why I brought this today. I brought extra copies. The one thing I noticed looking at the Swampbird property is there's an area down.
Which we already talked about.
It's dry.
Yep, exactly. That's the one I talked about a long time ago, is that's where the DP, it should go.
Yeah.
Because we have direct access on 53.
Yeah.
Bring the salt, if you're going to bring salt in.
Yeah.
It's a no-brainer.
Yeah. And or even if we had to do an alternate salt site or something, you could do it.
Well, that's where originally.
Not there. I'm talking on the plate piece that we just bought too.
Right, but the problem with that is that's all wet.
I looked in the area that's upland there.
Right.
It's upwards of like 18 acres or something like that.
Right. Well, that was when we purchased this property.
Yeah.
We had to go and we forced them to buy that back. Remember? To get that piece of property based on what we thought our needs would be.
Yeah. So. That was good. I just happened to notice it when I looked at this plan. I'm like, oh, let me look at this.
And it looks like it's access.
There might be some wetland replication, whatever, but that could be
plenty of room.
That could be part of the site selection, because it's way away from where any of the proposed wells, so.
Right. Yep.
Maybe we wanted to buy a piece of property after all. You would,
well,
Ben, we're all, buy property.
Wait a minute. Well, first off, it was...
Buy property.
First off, if we can go back to, it was me pushing to buy this.
I'm just kidding.
But because of multiple things, because of...
I'm just kidding.
Because this, right here, is going to become a 12-house subdivision. Which would have messed up the ability to even get any water.
So,
it's good.
That's it. So, okay, so, and sorry to interrupt. That's the annual town meeting article number one. Next, Route 14 drainage. So we're looking for another 50 grand.
Well, I met with Mike Buckley, and I come across in my packet for the Route 14 corridor project, Ed had signed a contract for $50,000, roughly.
Yeah.
For drainage that was outside Mass DOT's scope of work.
For where?
But the money was never allotted. So this is to make sure that the money's there when Mass DOT says, okay, that work's done. Now it's up to you to pay for it. That's the sedimentation tank and everything conservation wanted, across from Sampson Lumber, roughly. Big grass strip.
Okay.
To catch some of that drainage. Because the money we got was the yellow pot that's got to go in that drainage easement just beyond Ben's shop on Furnace Lane.
Right.
That everything direct drives right into the outfall.
But how much money are we spending out of this for the, to go across the, to the old cranberry bog? Are we spending money for that?
No.
No?
No. For the dredging project?
Correct.
No. I made them pay $5,000 out of that for the engineers to inspect that culvert to make sure it was all set when we got the Route 14 Carter project going on, because it was never looked at because it was private. Now the town owned it, I wanted to make sure it was all right for us as far as Route 14 goes, but
right,
for their needs when they do the dredging project, if that moves forward, so that was done.
So just out of curiosity, on that particular piece of property, didn't we have issues about where we were going to put drainage and we couldn't put it there because it was private? At the time, and now we own it?
I think maybe at the time.
So that's fine. Capital water projects, flushing program. I don't know if you saw that, Paul.
I did see.
Yeah. We have something at least, so.
Right, I saw that there was an old design, is that
the
one you're talking about?
Yeah, the 1996, whatever
right.
It was.
But we were talking about that was not exactly what we're talking about doing, though, is it?
Well, I took a little look at it. There's been so many improvements in 20 years with looping of water mains and a couple of transmission mains that aren't included in that. I think we should do it off the updated hydraulic model, because I think it's a lot different than when you start looking at what it wanted us to do back in 1996.
Right. Yeah, we've made a lot, actually been a lot of changes, subdivisions.
But we could use this year at least to get it done, because they're not going to finish this by the time we flush. They're not going to finish.
We're flushing in the spring.
Oh, we're flushing in the spring, not in the fall.
Well, I'll try and put it off till the spring. I think it'd be better results letting everything calm down over the winter and all the sediments settling with the low demands, and then hit it hard April and May, March if it's decent before the high demands kick in again.
So you think $10,000 is enough to do that?
Well, that's the cap you put on. The original proposal, I think, was 14.9 or something like that, and you guys put a cap on it at 10.
Yes.
Okay.
I'll do it for nothing before I give you 15 grand to
do. And that's just for the design, correct?
That's to draw I'm going to shut this valve, flow this hydrant, flow this hydrant. I know Ryan will come in and talk about it and tell you it's going to be more than that. But
that's
what I do.
Okay. And at the same time, we're going to go, I mean, I know we did a leak test throughout, didn't we already, to find out how much water was.
That was last year?
No, it was...
When was that?
2.5 years ago. So we've got money to do it this year,
okay,
again.
So we want to repeat that again, correct?
Yeah.
Especially
now
with all the work on 14.
Yeah. Right. We've already got the money to put that out to solicit the three prices.
Okay. Well, repairs.
Well, repairs, that was based on the quote from Mar.
Yeah, we'll be able to knock that down with the two other quotes.
Yeah.
For the other two wells, since we had money left over to take care of five now while it's offline.
Yeah, so we're gonna get all new pricing from...
For the other two.
For bids.
Yep.
And telemetry, my only question on telemetry is how are we bidding that? Are we gonna just give it to them, hybrid controls, 50 grand?
Well, we'll have to talk about that and decide that.
Because I think the thing to be would be write a request for the purchase of the radios. Because you can get the radio, he could just tell you, you know, I need 10 X radios. And then we put out a request for pricing on the radios. And that way we're covered. Because that's the bulk of the money is on the radios themselves. Swanberg Company pump test.
Now, you're talking about the two locations, correct?
Correct.
Talking about 10. And what was the other one, 3?
Right. One is the shallow aquifer, which is the well field.
Yeah.
And the other was the deeper aquifer for one well.
Right. Now, and has the 400-foot setback from...
That's the location that's the deeper, correct?
I would ask the question again, are we going to get pricing from anybody else on this or not? Are we just going to give it to environmental departments?
I think, as I recall, when we had it from, who was our other engineers, Steinbeck? Was it Steinbeck and Taylor?
Western Sampson.
That it was more money than what these people were asking.
That was done before I was in this position, so I'm not sure price-wise, Paul. How much they paid Western and Sampson for the testing that's already been done.
But it was, and that was only for, that wasn't as extensive as this pumping situation.
No, this is the next step in trying to go with your new source approval.
Right. Well, the only thing I'm interested in is getting it done quick, because we're going to have a situation.
I'm interested in getting it done legally.
Well, we can put it out to bid.
That's not
necessary.
That's not a thing.
Three
prices.
We put out to bid, get the three prices, but...
I can write up the scope of work and send it out to three people to get prices.
Right.
We can select whoever we want.
Because if we're going to be shutting five down constantly, especially if the aquifer doesn't, or the surface water keeps getting, is going to be affected by...
I'd have no problem with having it be an article. I just don't think we should just hand it to anybody because there's procurement laws and...
Right. No. Definitely has to go up to bid.
I don't want to be...
You know, caught in that.
Not procuring things correctly.
Right. No, that's fine. I don't have a problem with that. I think it needs to go up to bid. I'm just looking at... originally, we were kind of holding off, but one's a dead well.
I 100% wanted to do the project. I just don't want to say, here, go for it.
Now, just out of curiosity, because I know we're talking about what the cost is of a well, what's the cost of the structure or the building that we're going to need to do for all of the treatment?
I would say it's probably in the $2 to $5 million.
Is there any treatment out there, iron and manganese?
I think the way the rigs are going, every groundwater supply is going to need it for manganese.
Depends. It could be $2 million. If it doesn't need iron and manganese treatment, then you're looking at cheap on it.
Right. I think it.
You're looking at 100, 200,000.
If there's no treatment needed, the well itself is going to be probably 100 to 150 installed, and then the final production well. And then if you're just doing a regular pump station that just has corrosion control,
right,
you're probably looking at 200,000 to 300,000 for the station. And if you're looking at treatment, it depends upon the number of gallons or minutes you get out of there. I would assume one well, it's probably $2 million for a treatment plant.
Okay. No, yeah, I just want to know in my head what this is, the outlay is going to be.
Where we're headed.
Right.
It all depends. I haven't looked yet at what the water quality was out there in the preliminary phase of exploration.
Well, I remember when I was arguing for this project, there was questions about the quality of it, but it turned out it was the same as the rest of our wells.
Right. Like I said, our wells right now are just under the threshold of the new manganese.
I don't know. Just based on this, they don't mention manganese. in the well, they said iron, so maybe there's no manganese out there.
Be nice.
But like I said, if there's no manganese, then awesome. It's a, you know, I'd say awesome. $200,000, $300,000 is not a cheap project, but you have to do what you have to do to get water out of the ground.
Right. Well, it'll pay itself back because we're going to need it.
Next on the agenda. Route 14 update. Somebody asked me a question, I'm curious now. Did they relay out that issue with the bust on the survey that they originally had with the center line?
Yes.
Did they cut the trees down before or after they fixed that bust?
On which end?
I think pretty much on McQuan. McQuan Street end?
I think
that's the only change they made.
Oh,
and they pretty much went with the existing conditions and made them modify the plans to match the current.
Okay.
Instead of going back trying to redo it.
Yeah.
So they pretty much just went with the existing.
Okay, good. Because that was my question. I'm like, that's a good question. Because I don't want to. I mean, I would then go after. If they did, I'd say I want additional plantings.
Yeah.
If they cut down trees in the end because they didn't need to because they messed up on the survey, then. But
no, it was more
the
road profile
that
was off of them trying to redo the new road. So they made them go back, go off the existing, and change it for them to go by so it would be on their plans.
So up on Barker Street, by, is that Redbahn, that road? It's up down on the left.
Yes, Redbahn.
Looks like they've done some work there, maybe within the last couple of days, that's really low on their... I noticed the manhole cover is actually off, but it's quite a dip in the. Let me take a look at that because people are going to be complaining if it's going to be there for a long period.
I'll let you know if I find it because I haven't driven down that way in a couple of days, so that's why.
I noticed it today, but question is, I see that they've tied off further on the right as I'm heading towards the center. But I noticed that the catch basins are set in. Is that for the bike paths? What's the deal there? Is that for the sidewalk?
I think it's on the opposite side because the sidewalk's on Fairwood coming this way.
Right.
I believe it's still going to be on the paved surface in the end. It's just the surface is going to expand.
Right.
Either by shifting it with the sidewalk, shifting the whole road to the left or to the right, vice versa.
Yeah, I was just concerned.
I saw the same thing.
It looks like this, way into the roadway.
You mean way into the grass?
No.
I've seen some of them way into the grass, too.
Right. Yeah, but some of them are way into the roadway, and I'm not sure why.
I think that's the same reason, that it's just the shift of the road.
Okay.
That you're going to see then all of a sudden that sidewalk probably going to sit on top of the road where it exists.
And they'll have the berms to control that water.
I guess we'll find out, but they seem
to be moving fairly quick.
They're ahead of schedule because they've been throwing John, who's running the show, extra crews. So that's why the water guys have been running around like crazy, because they'll be marking out. All of a sudden, he'll give them, hey, I got another crew, and the crew, before they dig and say, hey, we don't have any services or anything marked in this area, so they got to go scramble to do it. So what they're doing now is the sidewalks have been started on McQuan. They're redoing all the drainage now for the roundabout, because they're planning on getting the roundabout in now before the winter.
Before they're going to hold off.
Yep. So they're trying to get the roundabout in, all that drainage, and then completing the drainage. Right now they're around Fairwood headed towards 53.
I see they're stocking poles and piping for...
National Grid subbelt the remaining 53 poles. So the company's out of one of the Bridgewaters, and I got the permission from upstairs now that we own that property to let them use that as a staging area. Otherwise, they got to go back and forth to one of the Bridgewaters, and they leave at 6:30 in the morning.
Right.
They can only bring five poles at a time.
Right. They got a previous stockpile there.
Yeah.
So that's good. I mean, they're moving along fast. And
I'm assuming Landers knows they own this all winter long.
Oh yes. Because what they've been doing is temporary patch with cold patch during the week, and usually Fridays they do a hot mix on them.
Gee, I mean, we're gonna have some 10-wheelers plowing with 14.
No, they don't know if plow.
Ours will.
Yeah, ours will.
We actually started hauling with our 10-wheelers today, finally, the sweepings and catch basins been stockpiled at the barn to the Middleborough landfill.
Gotcha.
So we finally got the permitting and all that stuff, and we're able to start hauling, starting today.
Okay, and the drainage up at the high school, is that all set now?
They're looming and seeding and getting ready for stabilization and all that, everything else is done.
And we didn't end up with any of that material?
I don't think they ended up with as much material coming out there as they originally planned, because they ended up, it was a stump dump, and they had to take all the stumps out of there and haul them to Marshfield, which they were talking about whacking us for a big time extra. I haven't heard any of that, so I'm wondering if they started looking at what they save, hauling fill and stuff out, maybe it became a wash, but there was a big issue with the legal stump dump that had been in that detention area, so.
Okay. Nice.
You all said 414?
Yeah, I just, so that, just out of curiosity, down by the ponds, they're gonna do that in the spring of next year, the crossing? For the
Culverts?
Culverts?
Yeah, they have to go through that 6-week window or whatever the Heron Fisheries gave them because of the Heron at all three of those culverts. So it'd be the one by Lindy's and the two up here.
What's the what's the window?
It's only like a 6-week.
But in the spring, 6 weeks?
Between spring and fall when they come back and forth. I don't know.
But isn't it a time of heavy waterfall?
That's what I was going to say. They gave them the worst case scenario. But hey, they own it. They
go.
I was gonna, that's what I'm saying, is if it's waiting until the spring. And
that
again,
would
like
perfect,
summer would have been the time to do it.
Because they don't have enough water to run.
Yep.
RFP we already went over. Website update. Rose?
Yes. So, we've been putting all of the updated stuff on the front page.
Uh-huh.
Because a lot of people go to that.
Yep.
I saw how you guys wanted to do another page for the DPW, strictly for construction projects.
Yeah.
Don't think we can get that at this time.
Okay.
Because we have so many pages. So it would have to be the same thing that I started doing, so that it would be each project, but it would be in the DPW under the highway.
Okay.
And all construction projects would be, you know, a brief description and the status.
Okay.
Speaking of that, sweeping.
Sure.
I know we're waiting to go out for bid. That didn't go anywhere, correct?
I've got the packages. I've just got to get it to three people.
Okay.
So basically we're waiting until this next break at this point, right?
I might bring them in. We're already on all the side streets.
Yeah.
So I may bring them in for a little bit in the fall, but it's mainly going to be for the spring to blitz it, depending on what happens this winter.
Okay.
Water master plans, I guess we got them, so.
We just got the draft.
Point,
I haven't had a chance
I'm assuming we're not going to talk about that.
I haven't had a chance to go through it for comments or anything yet either.
Anything else that we didn't have on the list? How's the mowers doing?
Yeah,
they're out. They're actually on West Elm Street today.
Maybe I can pull out of my street without getting killed?
Last week they did hold them, and then the lower end of Dwelly from all that rice weed grew out, and then today they were supposed to start on West Elm Street. Yeah, the issue wasn't the air conditioners. When I said overheating, it's the new design on the two newest ones.
Yeah.
The hydraulics were overheating and shutting everything down with all sorts of codes
safety
that they never had. So they came down, and what they ended up doing is they gave us two brand new hoods that they cut a bunch of louvers in to try and get more airflow in there. So temperatures have dropped, so it's not as hot as it was, but so far there hasn't been the issues that were shutting them down.
Good.
Well, the question, how long's the warranty on this? Only because it sounds
one
like
of those
bad
is brand new.
Right.
Well, yeah, it sounds like a bad design.
Well, that's the problem. Whoever the manufacturer was, it's run into these problems. The ones we bought it from are the ones making the modifications that we're bringing to their attention.
But who's the manufacturer?
Wacker over in Germany.
No.
That's why we were able to get two for the price of one. We're talking about for the next one, maybe going back to the trackless, even though it's more than double the price.
Well, the question is if they can fix the issues that it has, and it's durable enough. The question is, are they willing to extend the warranty, considering that they're putting it, that they're burdening the piece of equipment because of the design?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think we should be paying for less life.
I'm assuming we haven't paid for any of the modifications.
No.
And do they own any of the oil changes and things in the, you know, for, all right, so.
Put those on the list of never to buy again.
Already there for the mechanics.
Yeah. How are we for?
I have a question. I wish Scott was here. Is there any, what would the reason be for having two different plow routes, secondary plow routes, not primary and secondary, on the same street? Because I was trying to clean up.
I'd have to look.
I'll show you the routes, and I'll have to look. It might be just I didn't understand what he wrote, but you gotta get. The reason being is I'm trying to clean up the data so I can give it to you and Scott to maintain. But I have, the issue is this. In my mind, when I started the whole, it's a database. So in my mind, when I started the database, there was, is this street in a main plow route? Yes or no? That's a totally separate question. Is it 1, 2, or 3? And then, is it, what secondary plow route is this street in? And then I found that some routes overlapped each other. So I read the database, but then in the end, I can't show it on the map. That's going to be my second issue. So I guess the question is, is there a scenario, and if so, why? Because I can't think in my head why there would be a route that would have two secondary plow trucks on it. So I'll send you guys the ones that I found that are on two routes, and maybe I misunderstood what he wrote in the write-up.
He came in last week to get the routes so that he can go over them where he's home.
So yeah.
I can give you his email address. You can shoot him questions.
Okay.
And get back to him.
That's another good question that you brought that up, is when are we going to put out our rates for this winter coming up?
I think he was just going to take the routes and relay them out.
Right, we're going to sign up and start advertising that. So that, first off, be ahead of the curve instead of, you know, maybe some
people are going to wait until they get the height. It's almost, I would say wait, because if Norwell comes out before us and puts 15, and we were planning on doing 16, then all of a sudden we trumped him, and he already has his thing out. And we go up to 16, and we get the guys.
Plymouth County is trying to set up their meeting for the 22nd, on Thursday, for the superintendents to go over rates.
Yeah, because I preliminary talks with Scotty. I'd given him some that I had gotten through Bay State Roads. He was looking at them and figured we'd have to come to you guys for one more increase to try and stay in competition to get some of the bigger equipment, the trucks and stuff, as the surrounding towns. So I know he had some of that information too he was going to look at. Because I know Middleborough, talking to him, they're in Sodine, they just adopted Mass DOT's rates. So all their contract, they're paying whatever Mass DOT is paying.
So my goal is to have that fixed by next week, even though I said I'm going to have it fixed by this week.
Well, once some things happen, you get a young child, so.
I barely got this done in time.
You weren't yet.
No, almost getting close.
Then the fun starts.
Yeah. Anything else on the list?
Not that I can. Have you, now that the up on Cross Street, have you touched base with
them? I've had preliminary discussions with the site foreman. Either the end of this week or next week, I'll be getting with him again to meet out on site, because he believes they may start demoing stuff at the end of this week.
It's all fenced off, and yeah, I kind of want to be ahead of the curve on that one, because, you know, winter's coming fast, and they won't stop building, but they're planning on moving it fairly quick. Been an awful lot of money invested in just the permits problem.
Yeah. So yeah, I already had preliminary discussions with them about it, and we're going to meet out on site and come up with a game plan.
Okay. They were asking about the road opening permit. Will they get that done? And get their work done and have it taken care of before December 1st?
I'll have to talk to them.
Because that's one of the things you want to let them know.
Is this on Cross Street?
Yeah.
Well, that's, I mean, that's why we have to be ahead of the game, because they're gonna come in, they'll just, they'll grind that thing down.
What's our trench repair regulations?
I don't know, I'm sorry.
Do we require flowable fill?
Yes, right?
Not on all of them.
Most of them.
Mostly on main drags, usually only. So you may wanna take a look at that again, too. We just changed it,
So they, when whatchamacallit did that gas main, and it would look like Beirut for a year, that was flowable fill?
I don't believe so.
Why not?
The 6-inch main? 6-inch primary?
Yeah.
Was it?
I don't think so.
I don't think so, it couldn't have been.
I don't think so.
Well, you had the issue over on Taylor Street, after we had just done the...
No, but I'm just saying, like, a job like that should have been, it doesn't make, I could care less if the gas company has to pay an extra $500 a foot for flowable fill. I'm not saying...
No, we should take a look at that, though.
Well, one of the other things that we talked about was looking at upping the rates, because they had mistakenly sent me a check for a road opening permit. He charges them $50, Norwell charges them $100. So we were gonna look at changing our rates to what everyone else is charging.
What's the state charge?
I don't know.
We're gonna adopt adopting their rates.
Well, that's why the state requires flowable fill everywhere.
Right.
In the state right away.
Even on the gas main?
Half of it go into...
Well, the reason...
Or they require real compaction, like, protocol.
You know, when the planning board takes and does a subdivision, we put in there, you know, the state regs have to be, to meet those regs. So it's over in there, we should have that same thing here, where you have to meet those regs, and if it's flowable fill, it's flowable fill everywhere.
Yeah.
It doesn't probably cost that much more to do it right.
No, especially for like...
I can send you a copy of them.
If somebody's doing some dumb tap,
Right. Then
it's not that, we're not talking a lot of stuff, but that one?
Right.
I still look at that one, not in a bad way, at least, Landers is working, so I understand, like, I complained about the one, and it did get, finally got fixed, that the first bump, that was by the...
High Street?
Yeah. That was the first one that they had that was an issue, but they fixed it, they filled it in.
Right.
That one, I mean, that, like I said, as long as they know they own it this winter, they're gonna, because it's, and I mean they own it, because I'm not gonna sit there and go through Beirut again, because that was bad.
Because, I mean, like, the drainage from SDOT doesn't require flowable fill on their drainage.
I know, because they assume it's gonna settle out by the time the job's done, but I'm just saying that, if you let them know, I'm not gonna be driving over potholes all winter.
And everyone understands, now, all the utilities understand that once the road's done, was it 5 years?
5 years, unless it's an emergency.
And they have the opportunity now, if they wanted to put shut-offs on the outside of that road, where they can do it now.
We have no services we think should be renewed, right? Water services?
Well, if you read the master plan...
I haven't read it.
Which isn't gonna happen, because of Route 14 and Route 36 Carter project.
Yeah.
But one of theirs is... One of our biggest problems with the dirty water we're getting is the old mains that we've got the double mains on.
Yeah.
Because the flow is hydraulically from the transmission mains.
Yeah.
So you got the lower flow now when everything on the services are off.
Yeah.
So one of their recommendations is to take all the services off the old main, put them on the transmission mains, and then abandon the other ones in place. Well, it's not going to happen, because we just got Route 14 going now and Route 36 coming up. You're not going to be able to do that with those.
Get a price from Landers for a changeover.
Too far in the game.
Well, they could go back next spring, hang them up before they start reconstruction. They could do a portion of it. It's not to say they couldn't do a portion of it. I don't know if we have the money.
Make it a little better before 36.
After that, we're waiting 5 years. And then you never get, I'm not digging it up then either. No. Like, it's never getting, I mean, I'm not digging it up to fix services, that's for sure.
Unless it's the water, yeah, you're not gonna redo it.
You can tell Ryan that I asked him that question a year ago. He said, there's nothing I need to do on these two streets, right? Oh no, there's nothing I need to do on those two streets.
How big's the transmission lane?
16-inch.
And the one that everyone's feeding off of?
Eight.
Motion?
I make a motion to adjourn.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Remind him of that.
Did you stay up for the pass last night?
I did.
I fell asleep.
Because I was off this morning. I got to sleep.
The baby goes to sleep too early for me to stay up that late.
What time do you get up?
She gets up at 5:00 every day.
You're looking in this area?
Yeah.
That's what we were thinking originally.
You know, I'll be up to whoever gets selected. That'll be one of the sites that I would recommend them looking at.
Right, yeah. Because you do have that, you do have access to the restaurant.
Well, the nice part is if you put a well out there too, then all of a sudden the water department guys can hit that well the first thing in the morning when they do their rounds.
Well, right here, there's a, you know, a main feeder that runs through there?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the...
There's a water main.
Loop main from Oak to the backside of its water extension. Yeah, so you tie right into that 8-inch main.
Yeah. Well, that was, yeah, that's why we weren't going to buy the property because of that piece of property. He had broken off